It's all about supply and demand on both a national and global scale. Tommy Gomes, a San Diego fishmonger, works with boat captains to get the word out to chefs, wholesalers, and home cooks about today's fresh catch.
Hey everybody, Tommy the fishmonger down here. Opening day, California lobster season. We moved about 350 pounds in 45 minutes to the general public straight off of the boat.
He delivers his message through social media channels and connecting with consumers and buyers directly.
Just offloaded the boat. We're a little ahead of schedule. We're down here live, Driscoll's Wharf from Point Loma, Pacific Horizon. She's home as well. That means tomorrow they'll be selling tuna and opa and wahoo and all kinds of stuff. We'll be set up right here, selling live lobsters.
So we're hanging out at the crab buoy, and all of a sudden they put out three hors d'oeuvres, and there goes the whole gang. I'm the last one left, but they got live lobster down here at Driscoll's Wharf today. Come down and see my friends. They're over in the tank.
The rest of the country might be surprised to learn that California commercial fishermen harvest between 6,000 and 7,000 pounds of cold water spiny lobsters each season. Spiny lobsters have bigger tails, but no front claws like Maine lobsters. And the supply is stable and sustainable. That's the good news. The bad news, at least for American consumers, is that most of them are exported, mostly to China, where they'll pay a boatload for the spinies, which explains why I don't see them often on restaurant menus. Apex Wild Seafood is a major wholesaler of seafood, including spiny lobsters. David Shulkin, the company's owner, talks with Tommy about what's going on out there.
Dave, how's things going?
Quite well.
Things are going good at Apex, right?
Yep.
See, we got a little action in the back, right? What do we got? We got a little lobster back there.
We got our local California spiny lobsters coming in right off the coast from local California fishermen.
You sell domestic and export lobsters.
I do. Over the last couple of years, we've been working really hard to build more domestic market. Prior to that, a lot of it was going to Asia.
So right now, we got, I see Jin and your guys are busy. They're packing up some lobsters and separating lobsters and stuff
like that. We've got our crew going through and grading the different sizes of lobsters. We grade them to several different sizes for our local markets, domestic markets, and export markets.
What's one of your little hurdles that you have to go through here in the domestic market to get our local domestic seafood into our local consumers? What do you got for that? I mean, fire off.
Right now, the biggest hurdle is the export markets, to be honest.
Well, that's what we're here for. We're here to hear it.
It creates a lot of volatility in the market.
Uh-huh.
It's good for fishermen in a way because it increases price to them, so they're able to bring more money home to their families.
To watch this entire episode on Outdoor Channel, contact your TV provider today.